वेलकम टू शेयर द नॉलेज।
गुड आफ्टरनून टू एवरीवन। इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट एन सर्क्यूट। एक्चुअली दिस सर्क्यूट इन आवर हाई वोल्टेज इंजीनियरिंग वी यूज एज एन एप्लीकेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। एज एन एप्लीकेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू वी आर गोइंग टू यूज दिस वन, बट टू हैव सम मोर इंटरेस्ट टू क्रिएट some more interest and to have better understanding, I'm going to analyze this circuit. Anyhow, the same circuit we are go for the multi stages also, there also to have the better understanding. Initially we are going for the analyzing the complete circuit. Okay, the circuit is having a transformer. To the secondary of the transformer a capacitor is connected. For this combination, across this a diode is connected. To this entire combination one more diode is connected in series, and across this combination again a capacitor is connected. To this entire thing the load will be your RL. Okay, so please understand the main important element in this circuit is diodes and capacitor. Especially strict to the word, capacitors are the more important, plays a very very vital role here. Okay, this is the circuit to have the better analyzation. Okay, for ease of analyzing, I'm dividing this circuit as two parts. This is the first circuit and the second circuit. In the second, whatever the second circuit is there, it is acting as a load for the first circuit. During the first analyzing process, the second circuit will be act as load for our first circuit. So I'm going to analyzing of circuits. So I'm having the capacitor and the diode. Okay, and here there is an load resistor. There is a load resistor RL. This is the diode D1 and capacitor C1. So here the input voltage is Vin and the output voltage across your resistor will be Vout. Okay, so as we know that through the transformer AC will be the supply, so your input, okay, your input waveform should be a pure sinusoidal waveform. So I'm going to analyze first our sinusoidal input here. Please concentrate this point, because it is most important thing. Whenever we understand this sinusoidal waveform, then it is easy for us. So it is T by 4th second, it is T by 2 second, and 3 by 4, and it will be T, and this is your peaks, positive peak and negative peak. So the sinusoidal waveform we are representing as Vin as Vm sin omega t. That means the peaks will be Vm and minus Vm. Okay, so if you taken this one, the initial assumption we done is the capacitor. Okay, whatever the capacitor we considered here, it is not charged one. Okay, whatever the capacitor we considered here, it is not charged one. So already we know that whenever the capacitor, okay, whatever the capacitor we are considering, it is not charged. So if you provide any voltage to the capacitor, initially it does not allow any change in the voltage. Okay, so whatever the capacitor voltage before the operation, and the voltage across your capacitor after the operation, I mean after the start, is also zero, because previously it is uncharged capacitor. It is uncharged capacitor and it does not allow any sudden change in its voltage. Any change, sudden change in its voltage. Okay, so in first condition, I'm going to analyze this one up to the T by 4th second. Okay, the time limit up to, because it is charging. I mean, it is exponentially increasing. It is increasing the one. Okay, it is charging one. So I'm going to analyze the circuit for time limit 0 to T to T by 4. Okay, so up to this point I'm going to analyze here. So here whatever the voltage, okay, whatever the voltage is there, it is positive. Okay, the input will be positive one. Okay, input is positive one. Okay, again I'm going to draw the circuit, same circuit. So this is Vin and the voltage across your capacitor is 0 volts. Okay, the voltage across your capacitor is 0 volts. Okay, and next I'm going to see what is the status of your diode. Okay, when coming to the diode, diode will conduct from P to N. The diode will conduct from P to N, where your voltage at P must be greater than N terminal voltage. That means P terminal voltage must be higher. Right now the P voltage terminal is zero. It is grounded one, and your N terminal is positive, because now we are having the positive sinusoidal now. So it is positive and this is grounded one, that is zero. So this is higher polarity and this is lower polarity. So from lower to higher it won't conduct. So the status of your diode, okay, the status of your diode is open circuit. That means it is your diode D1 is off condition. You may consider it as an off condition or reverse bias condition, anything you may consider. And the voltage across your capacitor is 0 volts. So when diode is turned off, current through your diode is 0, but there will be a voltage drop. So whatever the voltage drop across your diode is there, the same voltage drop will be appears across your resistor also. Okay, so just we will see how it will be going to happen. Okay, so take the KVL for this loop. So minus Vin plus Vd equals to 0. Anyhow, you are having the capacitor also here. The capacitor is also 0. You may consider any direction. Either it is plus or minus, or minus or plus. Anyhow, the value is 0. So plus 0 equals to 0. So it forms a closed loop. So whatever the diode voltage, okay, whatever the diode voltage across your diode, whatever the voltage across your diode is nothing but, whatever the voltage across your diode is nothing but the voltage of your input voltage. Okay, voltage across your diode is nothing but your input voltage. Okay, so whenever this diode voltage is nothing but your output voltage, so across your output, across your output, whatever the input you provided, the same input will be APS. The same input will be APS. Okay, this is the thing happens up to T by 4th second. Up to T by 4th second, it is happening. Okay, please remember one more point. Please remember one more point. So when this resistor, okay, so this is your load resistor. Okay, the charging, this will be acting as an your RC circuit. This is acting as an your RC circuit. So the time constant, the time required for your circuit, the time required by your circuit for the complete charging or discharging, it depends upon its time constant. So for RC circuit, the time constant we provided as, okay, we provided as R equivalent into C. R equivalent equals to C. Here whatever the resistor, okay, whatever the resistance is there, it is very high. Okay, whatever the resistor is there, it is very high. It is very high. Then the total time constant, okay, the total time constant will be very high. Okay, whenever the time constant is high, the capacitor will not charge. The capacitor will not charge. Okay, so it takes more time to charge the capacitor. When the time constant is very high, the capacitor takes more time to charge. At the same time, if the time constant is less, I mean, if high means it is infinity, low means if it is zero, the capacitor will charge immediately. The capacitor will charge immediately. So here, as the time constant is very high, the capacitor will not start the charging. Even up to t by 4th second, the capacitor is not at all charging here. Please remember this point. So the final conclusions up to this t by 4th second is Vout is equals to your Vin, and the voltage across your capacitor is still 0 volts, and the status of your diode is off. So these are the conclusion points we draw from this, okay, from 0 to t by 4th second, okay, t by 4th second. Okay, So now I'm going for analyze the circuit for up to T by 2. Okay, T by 2. So again, I'm going to draw the circuit and we will cross check each and every element. So right now also the voltage across your capacitor is 0 volts. The voltage across your diode is 0 volts. Okay. And coming to your diode, till now it is open circuit. It is open circuit. Okay. So till now, that means before T by second. So up to T by 2 second, this negative polarity, okay, negative voltage is higher, so the diode will be turn off stage. So the same will be continued up to the T by 2 second. So the transition will occur whenever the negative cycle is applying. So now Okay, so now this is 0 volt, this is 0 volt, and this is negative. Okay, negative volt. So compared to zero and negative voltage, 0 voltage is higher. That means your V polarity, I mean voltage across the P terminal, voltage across at your P terminal is higher than your N terminal. So the conduction will be starts from your P to N. So the diode is going to turn on. The diode is going to turn on here. The diode is going to turn on here at T by 2 second. I mean at T by 2 second. Okay, this is P and this is voltage VD. Okay, so the diode is now the status is changed. Diode status is changed from off state to on state. Off state to on state. So the diode is turned on. Okay, so now again I'm going to apply the KVL here. Again, I'm going to apply the KVL here. Okay, so minus V in plus 0 plus VD equals to 0. VD equals to 0. Okay, so here once the diode is turned on, okay, once the diode is turned on, the representation of your diode, okay, the representation of diode as short circuit. Once the diode is turned on, it is represented as a short circuit. There will be a current through the diode. There is no voltage drop here. That means your VD will not be available. But where is this VD? But actually where this VD is there? This VD is available at your output terminal. So this is nothing but whatever the thing is there, it is nothing but V out equals to VD minus V in. So this is the voltage appears across your output terminals once the diode is turned on. Okay, once the diode is turned on condition. Once the diode is turned on condition here. Okay, so remember one more point. So now the diode is turned on. So the resistance of this diode, the resistance of the diode is very less. That means approximately 0. So now the time constant. Now the time constant will be RTH into C. So what is this RTH? It is the parallel combination. It is a parallel combination of your RL and diode resistance. RL and diode resistance. That means, so 0 in parallel with RL is nothing but the time constant will be 0. So I already stated that when the time constant is 0, the capacitor starts charging. The capacitor starts charging. Okay. So from this point, we are drawing the conclusions. We are drawing the conclusions that the capacitor is starts charging. The capacitor starts charging and the output, okay, whatever the output voltage, because it is connected in parallel with your diode, your output voltage is 0 volts. It's 0 volts, and the diode is turn on. Okay, so please understand the capacitor. Okay, the capacitor starts charging here. If you recall the thing, when we start the discussion, we stated initially from the negative terminal onwards, when I discussed this topic, instead of positive terminal, I stated the starting of your circuit will be there from the negative terminal. This is the way, this is the reason why I'm started here, because in the negative terminal, in the negative half cycle only, the capacitor starts the charging. The capacitor starts charging here. That is the reason why we taken there. Okay. So in this, the capacitor starts charging. So whatever the charging is there, okay, whatever the charging is there, it will be continued. Okay, it will be continued up to the voltage of V. Okay. So anyhow, in this circuit, so again we are going to draw the circuit. So it is short circuited again, and your load resistances and load resistance, and this is your input voltage. Okay, we know the capacitor is charged, the capacitor starts charging, so this voltage is zero, so the output voltage is also zero. Okay, so we know the capacitor is starts charging, but we don't know where in which polarity. Okay, plus or minus, we don't know that polarity. So again we just place that KVL. Okay, so for time being we just assuming this polarity, we just assuming this polarity. If it is differ, we may consider that minus plus, or the same polarity what we are using, it is holds good. So I'm just using here, this is 0 volts, this is zero across your diode, it is 0 volts when it's short circuit. So minus V in plus Vc plus 0 equals to 0. So the capacitor will be charged similar to your input voltage. The capacitor will be charged similar to your input voltage. Okay. Please remember here. So this is the thing happen from T2 to 3-4. From T2 to 3-4 it is happening. So please understand this concept. The input, okay, the input will be varies in each position. That means the input okay, please understand here, the input may be minus Vm, after some time it may be 0.099 of Vm. okay, minus Vm. So the value of Vin will be varying. The value of Vin will be varying. But the value of your capacitor, okay, the value of your capacitor, the value of your capacitor will not vary. The value of your capacitor will not vary. The value of your capacitor will not vary here. Okay. So the same voltage, okay, whatever the voltage is there, it will be continued there also. It will be continued in further cases also. Okay. So again, apply the KVL at 3T plus 4. That means we are going for analyzing the circuit at this portion. Okay, at this portion we are going for the analyzing. Okay, so now the Vn will be varying, this is complete Vn, it will be varying. So I am assuming it will be less than, for time being it will be less than Vin. Okay, less than Vin. Okay, so less than Vin. So I am just writing less than Vin, minus terminal, less than Vin, less than Vin, and minus of your Vc, minus of your Vc plus V out. Okay. equals to V out. So whatever this V out is there, okay, whatever this V out is there, it is nothing but V in, whatever the less than quantity of V in plus VC, plus the VC, okay. So for example, this VC, okay, whatever this VC is nothing but your V in. So whatever this output is there, whatever this output is there, nothing but 2V in, okay, it will be 2V in, okay. So I'm going to draw this all conclusions here. I'm going to draw this all conclusions here. This is T by 4th and this is T by 2 and this is 3T by 4, okay, again this is T and it is next cycle, okay, so I'm not considering this. Initially at output cell, this is the in my input, okay, this is my input, so I'm going for the output analysis, okay, output analysis from 0 to T by 2, okay, from 0 to T by 2 or up to T by 4, so what is your output, so whatever the input you provided, the same input will be APS. So I'm considering this as V in. Okay. So whatever the input I provided, the same input is appearing. Okay. So this is up to the T by 2. After T by 2, what is your output? Okay. The diode is short circuit. Okay. So whatever the diode is there, the diode is simply short circuited. So the output is 0 volts. Up to what time it has happened? Only for 3 by 4. Okay, up to 3 by 4, the diode is short circuited. So it is 0. So once it is beyond at 3 by 4, okay, 3T by 4, the value, okay, what is the value of your output? It starts charging, the capacitor starts charging and the output is appearing as 2 times of your input because the VC value, okay, whatever the VC value we consider it as, it is V in. So the combination will be 2V in. So from here onwards, it starts charging. Okay, this is for first cycle and this is for next cycle. So please observe this waveform. So up to this state, we call it as a transient and next cycle onwards, we call this as a steady state. We call this one as steady state. So up to here, this is the magnitude of Vm. Up to this, this is the magnitude of Vin. So again, one more Vin. So the total magnitude, okay, here, please observe, the total magnitude will be 2Vin. So you may understand this. At output side, two times of your input is nothing but doubling of your input is happens because of your circuit 1 because of your circuit 1. So the output here it is 2 V in. So I am going to analyze the second circuit in simple way. So this circuit is nothing but the peak detector. Okay. Sorry. So the second circuit is, this is your second circuit. So we are considering, we just provided some in a supply. We are going to supply this one. So when I consider this capacitor initially as uncharged one, okay, as positive cycle, the diode is turned on, the diode is turned on. So the capacitor starts charging immediately. The capacitor will start charge immediately because the time constant is zero. So it starts charging. So once it went for the charging condition, once it starts for the charging condition, there itself it will be stably settled down. So it will be stably settled down here. Okay. It again comes back to the discharging position. The capacitor can't discharge us. It will continuously stated in that position itself. So whatever the circuit, okay, whatever the circuit is nothing but your clamper circuit. Your first circuit is nothing but your clamper circuit, positive clamper circuit. And second circuit is nothing but positive peak detector. This is positive clamper circuit. And this is positive detector circuit. So the final output will be, okay, a constant magnitude, okay, of 2m, 2vm, because the output of your first circuit is 2vm sin omega t. Okay, the output of your first circuit is 2vm sin omega t. So the output of your second circuit will be constant 2vm. So at final, at load end, the output voltage is Vm. Okay, So the combination of your positive clamper circuit and positive peak detector circuit is nothing but your voltage doubler circuit. Okay, this is your voltage doubler circuit, and this is the complete concept. Okay, this is complete concept behind your voltage doubler circuit. But anyhow, it is not required in our high voltage engineering. Okay, which diode is turned on and which diode is turned off, what is the status of your capacitor, whether it is charging or discharging, we are not bothered about all these things. So we simply go for at positive cycle, this capacitor is initially uncharged. So from the negative cycle, we are going to consider, in the negative cycle, this diode is going to turn on, and this diode is turned off. And simply this forms a closed path. So the capacitor will charge us further Vmax. So whatever the applied voltage you are providing here, for this voltage, the capacitor will be charges. So this is Vmax in the negative half cycle. In the next positive cycle, along with this Vmax across your capacitor, and second of your voltage Vmax, both will combine and charges your capacitor to Vmax. So since the capacitor and your resistor is in parallel, the voltage across your load resistance will be 2 Vmax. This is the concept we are going to study in our high voltage engineering. We are not go through this all the time constants, how it is happening. This is the thing you can study in your analog circuits or power electronic circuits under the heading of clamper circuits and detector circuits. Okay. So the combination of these two circuits will give you voltage doubler circuit. I hope it will gives you a better understanding of the circuits. Okay, thank you.